YouTubers. We're down here with a big purple monster. This is what they do with the pieces that come in here. Then he picks them up over here, puts them up on the table. This is that splitter we built a few years ago. He'll push those down. That is, but it's up there. I know the elevator's 40 foot. That's the I can't see anything in here. That's the first pile up there. This is the second pile. They moved it back. I'm guessing that's probably 20 foot high. All oak. It would break down when you're here. I think think a piece went in there sideways. Like a piece got in there sideways. Looks like it's working pretty good. What, you got a piece in there sideways? You're just about done, aren't you? Just in time. Now we got cleanup. No. Table goes up. Hey! I can get up there or not. Thank you. good job. I don't have to do this, but thank you. a few runaways. Jeffrey's down there grading up the mess. That thing, I don't know if you can hear me or not. If you can, I'll explain it. This thing is up so high because you can't fit it on the elevator just right. So it's easier to just jack that thing up and move it up so some of that stuff doesn't fall down. We got some kind of fabricate a little bit better setup here. But, you know, you figure in 2 days, he's got probably, I don't know, enough cords to make it through the winter. He's got a bunch already stacked up in the barn. We'll go in there. There's another one of the wedges for it. Splits the stuff a little bit bigger. Here's the old truck. You remember seeing that? I think I showed, maybe I hadn't showed the completed thing. But he's got eight loads of wood in here already. Eight loads of wood in there. He usually has wood, another eight over here, but I guess he's not gonna do that this year. There's the foundry that we make things from time to time, cast different things. There's the that 084. Those are two of the saws that were down there yesterday. Widgets, things to pack it down with. Just stuff. In fact, up there is the air dogs for my number one mill if I ever get that thing going. Anyhow, maybe you can hear me better in here. That's up so they can push the splitter in further so the stuff will drop on the conveyor. We got to put a trough on the back of that, but you know, for the little bit of debris that comes out of there, it's just about as easy to just set it up there and let your run go. Anyhow, thought I'd show you what we do with those big pieces from that. You'll be seeing me post some of them. I'll probably put this one on tonight. When we make those big pieces down there and then split them into manageable pieces, so it's got one more split before it goes up on the table, that's how we break down the stuff. I think it probably took them, wouldn't be surprised, took them 3 hours to make that pile. So, and I have no idea how much wood's in there, but there's a lot. If you like this kind of thing, do me a favor, hit the like button. It doesn't cost you nothing. It will help me out. And hit the subscribe button. I guess I got past videos of this on there. It's a four-cylinder John Deere motor, which was donated. The trailer was donated. The hydraulic cylinders were all donated. That valve block was donated. He made the tank. The fuel tank is just a bought tank at the store, so we don't really have a whole lot of money in that. Almost all the steel was free also. Now they did buy the big plate that made the table off the back, but the cylinders that were on that were also giveaways. So we latch on to stuff and make things, so that's what it's come out to. So anyway, I'll hit the like button, subscribe if you would, and see you later. Bye.